I'm Dr. Wael Tantawi. I'm presenting the case on behalf of Dr. Fatma Khadour. He's a 46 years old male. He is recently discovered to have a hypertension within the last 9 months, and he's only on ACE tablets. He had recurrent attacks, actually two attacks of chest discomfort, and nausea and loss of consciousness for a few minutes, but no other acute symptoms. These attacks were two syncope attacks, as he injured himself on one of the attacks, and the other one was witnessed by his wife. His wife gave us a history that he has rigidity, stiffness, and after a couple of minutes, he became flaccid. After this, he needs some time to recover completely. He presented to our hospital, and he was admitted for investigation. All his vital signs and investigation showed no abnormality. His ECG, echo, Holter monitor, and 48 hours were done, and there is no abnormality. His coronary angiography showed normal coronaries about 4 mild LAD bridge. EEG was done for him 3 times, and it showed either alone or with a sleep deprivation, and it was also normal. Brain CT was done, and it was within normal limit, and even tilting double test was done to rule out vasovagal attack, and it is normal. So this is his echo, which was entirely normal. LV injection. His coronary angiography also is normal. And this is non-small non-dominant RCA. So this patient, after all this investigation, he was planned for discharge and only medical reassurance. However, in the day of discharge, he had similar attack of the same chest discomfort followed by nausea, and he was observed by the nurse, and he lied down on the bed, and he went for loss of consciousness. ECG was done at that time and showed heart rate of 40 and blood pressure was 90 over 60. The patient recovered after 1 to 2 minutes. His ECG that time showed. So we can find that there is ST segment elevation and significant ST segment depression. ST segment elevation in the inferior leads with a cervical depression in the anterior leads. So the patient was admitted on the telemetry ward. So we went back and we reviewed his telemetry at this time, and we found that he has significant bradycardia and couplets with junctionalism. So in summary, this is a 46 years old male with recurrent attacks of loss of consciousness with bradycardia, AV block, and significant ST segment elevation. So we have the differential diagnosis of vasospastic angina with secondary seizure or autonomic seizure with cardiac effect and exaggerated vasovagal response, which was already ruled out by the tilting table test. So even his management was a little bit dilemma for medical treatment, session of permanent pacemaker for this patient, or loop recording and observe, or we should go for all of the above. However, we selected to go for the medical treatment. The patient kept for medical treatment for a few days, and he was doing fine and discharged home in good condition. Thank you.